Shabbat shalom, shalom, greetings in the mighty name of Jesus. Shalom, everybody. Amen. I want to say greetings to everybody out there. I want to say thank you and much love to our subscribers. Amen. We've been praying for you. Bless the Lord. That the Lord keep you. Amen. And he sustain you. Amen. On your missions. Bless the Lord. Bless all of you. Click like and subscribe and send this message round. This one is called Taking the Limits of the Most High God. We bless the Lord. Now we know that we've been living in troubled times. Amen. It's been a challenging year for all of us, to say the least. Some of us have been betrayed. Some of us have been hurt in other ways. Some of us have lost loved ones or are still very lonely for different reasons. Some of us are coping with stress, depression, somebody's suicide, or considering it themselves. But I want to encourage you tonight to take the limits of the Most High God. This is not the time to not believe and to stop believing. Mm-mm. This is the time more than ever to hold on. I know there's a lot of spiritual confusion out there. Different messages coming from places that you trusted. Amen. But you know what? The Bible said, trust not in the arms of flesh, for the arms of flesh will fail you. You dare not trust your own. We bless the Lord tonight, because God is faithful to his word. He said, I change not. He sent Jesus to tell us that Jesus has gone to prepare a place, that where we are, where he is, we may be also. Bless the Lord. I'm allowed one error. Amen. I'm allowed one error. The enemy's desire, though, is to plant seeds of doubt and hatred, unforgiveness, malice, grudges. That's his job, to plant those seeds. And it's the Holy Ghost, with our cooperation, that gets those seeds out of our chest. Yes, I said chest. Because when we stand before the Father, amen, he's looking for that mustard seed sin as well as the mustard seed faith. Amen. Bring all that is impossible to the Father. Amen. We got a note, letter from Africa. Young lady said, my husband's down on the ventilator, my daughter's down, and now my nephew. Now I need the ministry to pray. We prayed and the Father said, on the third day, that man's going to be up and ready to go. Third day came, I never heard anything. I wrote back, only to hear they were so excited. The drama. He woke up on the third day and said, I need a phone. I need a phone. And then she called me again when they were all at home. Daughter, nephew, and husband alike. Taking the limits of the Father. He's not limited to one spot, one place, one country. If we come together in prayer, the impossible can happen in Jesus' name. It's impossible for him to lie about that. Hebrews 6, verse 17 to 19. He says, impossible to lie. God is not a man that he should lie, or the son of man that he should ever lie. Why do they believe he's lying? Because people are losing faith. People are losing hope. With all what's going on, it's too much for some. Especially if they're alone and they're up in age. We pray for grandma in Utah. Clocking 95 and still going strong, but lonely. Miss her friends and her family. And everything's going on around her. We pray for those people. We pray for her right now in Jesus' name. Let us not lose hope. Bless the Lord. Let's take the limits of the Father. Numbers 23, verse 14. Take the limits of God. Let's not lose hope. Let's see Romans 8, verse 25. Let's see Psalm 71 and verse 14. And let us not lose hope. Let us not lose hope. But rather go to 2 Corinthians 4, verse 16 to 18. Numbers 23, you know, is letting us know. Take the limits off the Father. Yes, you've lost a few friends. Okay. You are in mourning. You've lost your job. Things are tight. There's no peace. Nowhere. Matthew 5, 1 to 3. Psalm 73, verse 26. John 11, verse 25 to 26. 2 Corinthians 15, verse 42 to 44. 2 Corinthians 4, 17 to 18. And 2 Corinthians 5, verse 8. And don't forget Romans 14, verse 8. We're not here to lose hope. We're not here to lose hope. Our hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. We're not here to trust those sweet frames, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. Sankey Man said, what a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. Sometimes we've got to go back into Sankey to find salvation also. But Numbers 23 and 14 is still crying out to take the limits of the Most High God. Let's not limit God, especially in this season. Isaiah 41 verse 10 said, fear not, I am with thee. And Jesus said, behold, I stand at the door and I knock. If any man hears and he opens unto me, I'll come in. Take the limits off God. Take them off. Our key Psalms this week was taken from Psalms 118. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, and his mercy endures forever. His right hand does valiantly. His right hand does valiantly. Do you hear that? We bless the Lord. Walk your corridors and say, I shall live. I will not die. 118 verse 17. I shall not die, but I shall live. Verse 19. Open the gates of righteousness, and I will enter into them, and I will give thanks, sincere thanks unto the Lord. We bless the Lord. He said, I beseech thee, O Lord, to save us. Save us now, we beseech thee, O Lord. Verse 25, for the Lord has given us light, order, the festival, the procession with boughs, even unto the horns of the altar. For thou art my God, and I will thank thee. Thou art my God, and I will exalt thee. My friends, tonight, on this Sabbath day, we have to remember that we're always going to have haters. You know, I get a lot of letters complaining about, I have so many enemies, I've got so many people that hate me. How can I find peace in God like that? By remembering that his mercy endures forever. We can't please all the people all the time. We can't even make peace with all the people all the time. But if it's possible, live in peace with all men. Amen. That's what Paul said. Out of my stress, out of my distress, verse 5, I called upon the Lord. So when we find ourselves in distress, call upon the Lord. Find that quiet place. Just take that moment away, or just close your eyes and talk from your heart to the Father. Amen. He answered me with great enlargement. He answered me and put me in a great large place. Because when we're going through, friends, everything looks narrow. The way looks short, narrow, and tight. Everything's tight. Your chest is tight. The way is tight. Life is tight. The news is tight. But the word is encouraging us tonight. He said, look, in my distress, I called upon the name of the Lord. And he put me in a large place. That means he took you out that tight tunnel where everything's tight. And when you call upon in distress and he makes the way, now the way looks larger. You can see the things around you and appreciate them more. Because you're not just looking on that problem. I'm talking to somebody. We can't afford to lose anymore. Recklessly. We just can't afford it, friends. I implore you tonight to seek the Lord while he may be found. Trust no man and trust no prince. Amen. They'll come around you and they'll come pass around you. Amen. But trust not the man. Verse 8. It is better to take refuge in the Lord. Trust not even a prince. All nations are going to come around you. Verily, in the name of the Lord, you got to cut them off. They'll come around you. Verse 11. Verily, in the name of the Lord, you're going to have to cut them off. Amen. Why? Because we can't trust anybody. Amen. The arms of flesh will fail you, the word says. He doesn't lie. God is not a man that lies. It's impossible for him to lie. Bless the Lord. He's going to tell you the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. And the truth is, he was wounded. He was bruised. And by his stripes, we can still be healed. And don't let anybody tell you where you are in God or with God. That's something between you and God alone. Amen. When people are reading the outside, God reads the heart. God knows when your heart has changed. God knows when you've turned to him again. God knows when you've returned. And God knows when you've rejected him. And we bless the Lord. He is watching keenly over his people. He said, I am the good shepherd. I am the chief shepherd. All shepherds are under me. The world is mine and the fullness thereof. When King David came to realize this, that everything he says and everything he does, the Father already knows about that. He said, let the words of my mouth then and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Job said, though he slay me, yet will I see him. He never gave up. And we don't want to find ourselves down Job Street. Amen. We don't want to find ourselves being tested by the devil just because we're there. Jesus never come at the time of Job. Jesus come after the time of Job. So we are blessed. Job didn't see him, but he still believed in the Father. Thomas saw him and doubted. But we didn't see him, but yet still we believe. We are the blessed group. It might not look like it, but we're the blessed group. Because it's written in the book of Revelation to John on Patmos. He saw a multitude coming up to the Father. Who are these? Where these people come from? And a voice from heaven said, these are those who have passed through great tribulation. Great tribulations, and have washed their robes, their lives, in the blood of the Lamb. But I stand accused. Do you? So did Joshua stand accused, my friend. Yes, and the angel of the Lord said, Satan, the Lord rebuke thee. And he gave Joshua a whole new suit of clothing, white. And he took off the dirty garments stained with sin. But I've been going a different way. Jesus did call me, but I went another way. Really? So did Jonah. So did Jonah. And when Jonah cried from the belly of the whale, God heard him. So you see, there's no excuse. It doesn't matter. I denied Jesus. I denied him. I denied him in the way I dressed and the places that I went to. Yes, Peter denied him 3 times too. And the Father said, upon this rock, I'll build my church. And the gates of hell will not prevail against it. Doesn't matter what it looks like, folks. The gates of hell will not prevail against the church of the living God. The church that Jesus died to establish will not be overthrown by Satan. God is going to win. This is the news I've come to give you tonight. We're taking the limits off of him now. It doesn't matter what it looks like. It doesn't matter what they've told you. When man is planning, God wipes out. All things are in his hands. Our steps are ordered by the Lord. He knew the day we were born, how we were going to sound, how we were going to look. He fashioned us. There's nothing he doesn't know. Have confidence in him, even if we're in grief. That's a hard time to have faith. When you're grieving, I know. I've been there. It's hard to have faith when you can't breathe. When your head's killing you. Your chest hurts. Your back hurts. I know. I've been there. It's hard to have hope when you're chained to a wall. You're imprisoned. You're incarcerated in some kind of way. I know. I know. But these are the times when God likes to show up and show out. Ashadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Ask Abraham when they were sentenced to the flames. How that went. How that worked out. Tonight, I encourage you to take the limits off the Lord our God. Bless and be blessed. Be strong. And share strength in the unity of the Holy Ghost. And remember, God is able to do all things through Christ who strengthens us. May God bless you. May God keep you. Cause his light to shine upon you and give you peace. And may the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the full fellowship of the Holy Spirit continue to rest. Continue to remain and abide with you, even now and forevermore. Bless you now, in the name of Jesus, from the Remnant Bible School Church. In Jesus' name, amen.